بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب زدني علما.
Okay, so next thing we'll talk about IPv4 subnetting. So subnetting is an advanced to IP addressing concepts. So we'll talk about IPv4 subnetting, what is FLSM, what is VLSM, and then finally we'll also see some subnetting questions. Now, first thing, what is subnetting? Subnetting is defined as a logical subdivision of one single network into multiple smaller networks. In simple words, we can say that dividing one single large network into small networks. So the main reason of doing this is to minimize the wastage of the IP addresses. So let's take an example to understand why we do that and what is the requirement behind doing the subnetting. So if you take an example, I have a four departments, let's say accounts, marketing, sales, and HR. So let's say there are four departments and each and every department have around 50 users in each and every department. And they all are connected in the LAN. Let's say they all are in the LAN. Physically, there is a connection for 200 devices, which includes 50 in each department. Now, once we do the physical connection, the next step is we need to assign the IP address. So we decided to assign the IP address, but we also decided that each and every department should be in different networks because I don't want the communication to happen between these four departments. Logically, I want to separate them in four different networks, even though they are physically on the same LAN. So in that case, we need to go with the IP addressing. Let's say I decided to go with 192.168.1.network for accounts department, and I'm assigning the IP address starting from 192.168.1.0 to 255, let's say. Anyway, this is the range of IPs, what we get. In that, maybe I'm assigning, let's say, 1 to 50. Because anyway, the first and the last address I cannot use. Out of them, I'm just using only 50 addresses. Now, similar way, for the marketing department also, I'm using a separate subnet. I'm using 192.168.2.network. And for the sales department, I'm using 192.168.3.network. And for the HR department, I'll be using 192.168.4.network. Now, logically, these are in different networks because we learned in the IP addressing that it's a C-class address. In the C-class, there are three network portions. And if the network portions are different, then we call them as different networks. So this is how we do, because my requirement is I want all the four departments should be in different networks. But again, the issue or the problem here is total we get around 256 addresses. Of course, two I cannot use, the first and the last. Out of 256 addresses, I'm just using only 50, which means approximately around more than 200 addresses are simply not used. Similar way, if you take the same example here also we get 200 plus addresses not used. Here also 200 plus addresses are not used. And likewise, 200 plus addresses are not used. If you just count, so it's like, you know, almost 800 addresses are not being used or not being assigned to any device in the network. So this is one possible scenario where, you know, there is something like the wastage of IPs. So if you take another example of a service product network, like yesterday we have also seen in the previous class, like the AINA is going to reserve the IP addresses to their local registries, RIRs, regional internet registries, and then they will allocate them to the service provider. So basically they get a block of addresses. Let's say this service provider got a block of 190, some public IP. Let's say service provider gets a block of 200.1.1.subnet, the complete C-class network, and 200.1.2.subnet, 200.1.3.subnet. These are the blocks or the subnets what I was allocated, means the service provider being allocated. Now, the job of the service provider is to allocate them to the end users, that is to the customers. So there's a company called ABC, A, B, and C, three different companies. Now, they need some public IPs. Maybe the requirement of this customer A, let's say, is just 10 public IPs. So maybe he needs 10 public IPs, and maybe the requirement here is just 4 public IPs, or the requirement here is just 2 public IPs. So the problem here is, by default, this is the smallest network. So what is the smallest network? C-class. C-class supports 256 addresses. B class supports 65,536 addresses, and A class supports this many addresses, right? 16 million addresses around. So probably the smallest size is C class. So which means I'm going to assign, so the service provider need to assign one subnet. So you cannot use same subnet for all. Basically he will be using assigning this subnet and this subnet and this subnet to this. The problem here is the requirement is very small, even smaller than 256. So basically what we need to do is in this kind of scenarios, the service provider cannot go and allocate the complete subnet. So what the service provider has to do, something called subnetting. So what service provider will do is whatever the class, C class subnet, he will divide into small networks and he will allocate this small network to one of the customers. Now the same thing we do here. So similar way here also, what we are doing is by default, let's say this is my C class network, which is starting from 0 to 255, these many addresses. So we are going to divide them into small networks. Let's say I'm dividing them into four networks, each network a size of 64 into 4, 256. So each subnet, I'm going to allocate this to the accounts, and I'm going to allocate this to the marketing, this for the sales, this for the HR. So this is what subnetting. So subnetting is a method of dividing one single subnet to multiple smaller subnets. One default network, we are dividing into multiple smaller subnets. The main use is, the main advantage is we minimize the wastage of IPs, because here if you see my requirement is just 50, sort of 64, I'm just using only 50. Means still, you know, there is a slight wastage because you cannot divide exact 50, that's not possible. But again, better than this one, right? 256 minus 50. So what we are doing, we are just using the 50 addresses out of the given block. So not only 50, it can be 100, it can be 10, it can be 2, it can be any requirement. Depending upon the requirement, we will be dividing the network. And this process is called subnetting.